So we'll start. Okay, right click, click on the customize toolbar, restore all content, okay, restore position, okay. So we will able to restore all the commands by using this process. Okay, so click on this sketch and click on this space. Okay, we will see one by one. Okay, while designing this part, initially we will design this boss, after that we will design this, and after that we will design this, and finally here is one part, we will design this step by step. Okay, so we will check these dimensions, we will check overall dimension. Okay, this outside diameter is 280, and inside we will remove material at the end. So this is 280 and height is 225. Okay, so take the circle. So circle diameter is 280. So to change it, just double click on it and give it 280 and click on the exit workbench command, and total height is 225. So click on this pad and give 225 divided by 2 and just click on mirror extend. So half will be at the top of this sketch and up will be at the bottom, so total will be 225. 112.5 plus 112.5, it will be 225. Okay, so click on OK. We have designed the middle boss. Okay, next we will design this. Okay, so if you observe this sectional front view, we have top it, we have that at the top also and at the bottom also. Okay, we will draw at the top and after that we will mirror it. Okay, what is the dimensions? So from center it is 175 and bigger arc diameter is R50 and inside that 47. Okay, so click on sketch, click on this face. Okay, click on axis, draw horizontal axis. Okay, we will take the help of this circle as a reference. So just project it, click on the project 3D element, click on it and again draw one more axis vertical, which is at a distance 175 from center. So click on this constraint, this axis to this point, it is 175. Okay, and diameter radius is R50 and we have to just extend that length. So take the circle, it is of R50, give the dimension, just double click on it and click on this radius and it is 50. Take the profile, take this point and just extend this line. Make sure that this line must be horizontal. Okay, select this mirror and give this axis, so on both sides it will be mirror. Okay, we will now trim this unwanted lines. So just double click on quick trim, remove this also, we don't need this. Yeah, we want closed loop and we have closed loop, remove this also. Okay, so if you observe, we have just one single closed loop which we have required. So on one side there is tangency, on other side there is no tangency. So just select it, press Ctrl, select the circle. So go to the constant dependent dialog box and click tangency. So that will be helpful in accuracy. Click on exit workbench, and how much it is? It is, if you observe, 32 total width. So click on pad and reverse direction and give the dimension 32. Okay, so we need three such boss. So just drop down here, select this pad and go to the, here is option is available with us, go to the circular pattern and give this reference as this, and select the complete crown, means total crown, and we want 3. Yeah, okay. On this side also there is same. So because this circular pattern cannot be mirror, okay, so we need to draw it again. So click on the sketch, click on this face and click on this fit all in. Okay, so you just project this, so it will get we will able to use this sketch. So click on this project 3D element and click on it, and that's it we have to do. Okay, again exit workbench, okay, and pad, reverse direction, and dimension is 32, and we will make the circular pattern. Click on the pad 3, click on this circular pattern and give this reference, click on OK. Okay, so like that we have designed it. Okay, so next is if you observe here, there is some material is added on this side, and if you observe this view, we will get the details. So this outer means this is of 5 to 100, and the material is added from 160 from this to, so we have to 160 or 180, yeah 160. Okay, so just take the top view, otherwise we'll check here. Just go to the top view, okay, and here also if you observe, so this is the our boss that we have to make. So here if you observe, in between these two we have to make the boss. Okay, so for that purposes, just offset this plane. Okay, so we'll do it. Click on the plane, click on this, and it is 160 and reverse direction, click on OK. Okay, so just click on the sketch, click on this face, and it is of 200, so go to the circle, and it is of 200, click on constraint, diameter is 200, click on exit workbench, pad, up to next means it will extend up to next surface. Click OK. Okay, this material that we have added. Okay, so next is, if you observe on this view, so there is some additional material is also on this side, means opposite to this, and which is at 3 to 5 distance from here, so it is of 575. So same way, just take the plane and select the surface and give this distance 3 to 5 and just mirror it. Okay, and click on OK. So again go to the sketch, select this face and click on fit on heel and draw the circle of 575. Click on exit workbench pad and here also same up to next. Okay, so if you have to next, if you observe, so such type of material will be add. Okay, so like that, still now we are just added the materials, and this is the standard method of industry, they how they are working. Okay, so industry also there is always they are adding this material as at the first, and then they are removing step by step like that. Okay, so now we'll remove these materials. Okay, so we have initially this major material, so 194. Okay, so click on the sketch, click on this face and draw one circle having radius 194. So having radius 194, so click on exit workbench and click on the pocket and instead of dimension up to last. Okay, so like that we have to do it. Okay, and next we will remove this material. If you observe, this is the counter bore and it is of diameter 100. Initially measure is major hole is 100 and it is 25 depth, and smaller is of 56.2 and it is of 2310 depth. So take the hole command. On this face there is a counter bore, so select this face and click on positioning sketch, so we will able to give the position. So select this point, press control, select this circle and go to the constraint defining dialog box, make it concentricity. Okay, and click on exit. Okay, so so in type go for, instead of simple go for a counter bore, and major diameter is 100 and depth is how much it is 25. So depth is 25. In extension, okay, click on okay. In extension, smaller diameter is 56.2 and depth is 310, and in type here is 25, just to make it 25. So major is 100, 25, and click on extension, smaller is 56.2 and 310 depth. Okay, and click on OK. So like that we able to make the counter bore. Okay, next we have now these three holes, and here is this holes which are having remaining. So this is of 547. So click on this hole, click on this face, positioning sketch, select this point, press control, select the circle, constraint depending dialog box and make it concentricity. Okay, click on exit workbench and here go to the type. Now this is not a counter bore, so click on simple. So these are the simple holes, and now come after in extension and extension. In extension, what is the diameter? It's 47. Yeah, diameter is 47 and depth will be 32, like that. Okay, so like that, and just we will pattern these holes by using the circular pattern command that we have. Click on the circular pattern and give this reference, and how much we income give this complete crown, and we want 3. Just click on preview. Reference that we have selected is wrong, so click on this reference and give this inside reference, like that, no problem. Just give the circular reference. Okay, so like that. On other side of face also, again take the hole on this side of face, click on positioning sketch, select this point, press control, select this circle, go to the constraint defining dialog box and make it concentricity. Okay, again click on exit workbench and it is a 4732 borrower, right? This is right. Okay, click on OK. And same, go to the circular pattern and give the reference. Reference must be circular because we are doing the circular pattern. So click on this inside boss also, no problem. Otherwise outside also, no problem. And 3 and 120 like that. Okay, so like that we have made this holes also. Last is remaining, that is 20.3 hole. It is of depth, I mean 20, it's not given, but it's 20 depth. So click on this hole, click on this face, because we are going to make this hole on this face. So click on position sketch. Okay, so we'll check this PCD. PCD is not given, but consider it 150. So just take this hole and draw one hole and give draw one construction or circle having diameter is 150. Okay, so select this hole, press Ctrl, select this circle and go to the constraint depending dialog box, make it coincidence. Okay, select this point, press Ctrl, select this horizontal axis and constraint dependent dialog box, make it coincidence. Okay, exit. And what is diameter? It is 20.3 and depth is 20. Okay, so like that. And we need this three holes, so just click on this circular pattern and give the reference circle, give the circular reference. So we'll give this reference and it is 3 means 120. 360 divided by 3 is 120 and click on OK. So like that we have completely designed this parts. Okay.